Today, I'm headed to a little boutique.
And I'm going to try on pants for the first time in over 10 years. And what I really want to try are blue jeans. So I'm hoping the swelling has gone down with my sutures. But I went to a local doctor to get some new bandages, and they put a wound vac back on me. But I'm not letting that hold me back today. I'm gonna find a pair of jeans that will fit, and I'm trying them on. And if I look as good as I hope in them, I'm buying them. I currently don't own a single pair of pants. And I've been waiting for this day forever. I never, ever really believed that I would be at this point. And I am.
I look cute.
I feel good in them. I feel womanly and sassy. It takes a lot for me to feel sassy. When I look at myself in the mirror, sometimes it's hard for me. I have to kind of like readjust my eyes because I don't believe that I'm seeing what I'm seeing. But to be able to start to resemble what I felt like on the inside, it's extremely powerful. That confidence is something to fight for. I'm excited to wake up every day and put on new clothes.
Thank you. Your new pants and your top, girl.
Yay.
Thanks for coming in.
Thanks so much. All right. See you later.
See you later.
Bye. So I'm really happy right now about everything, about how my body is starting to look, about how I feel, about all the new and exciting things I have in my life, and about all the possibilities that I have now. Tonight, I'm headed to Bruno's Little Italy. It's a little Italian restaurant downtown. And I'm gonna spend the evening with Mark. And I'm excited to see him. I was away for so long, and I haven't really been able to see him and spend some good time with him. So I'm really looking forward to this.
Hey, boo. Look at you all dolled up.
Aw, I see. How's it going?
Good.
How's parking?
Things have been going really well between us, and I like him a lot.
Jelani's butter.
He's a really good guy, and I have a lot of fun when I'm with him.
Thank you.
And the more time we spend together, the more I can see the possibility of a future between us. And that alone is incredible to even be able to think. 2 years ago, when I started this journey, I just completely shut down romance, love. I just had accepted the fact that it was never gonna happen. Like, I don't know where things are gonna go with Mark, but the feelings that I'm having, the love and affection I feel from him, that's what I want. That's the part of myself that I covered up for so long. And I'm so thankful that losing this weight, having surgery, has helped me achieve all of that, and I'm able to feel those things, and I would not trade who I am right now in this moment for anything in the world. I'm about to head to Houston for my next doctor's appointment, and now that I'm so small, I decided I can make these trips down on my own, and that I can fly my own now. It's been a really long time since I've flown, and so just the logistics stresses me out.
Chauffeur's here.
Hey.
Chauffeur's here.
How are you, Mark?
Goodbye, guys.
All right, see you later. Bye. Even though I know I can do this now, I'm still really nervous about it. I still think of myself in a lot of ways in a 600-pound body. So the fear of, will I fit into the seat is very real. But I know I'm ready to do this.
Look at that.
And I even had to tighten it. Now that I'm here and I fit in the seat with no problem, I'm just excited. This is an incredible feeling. And in a way, this opens the whole world to me because now I am physically able to travel almost anywhere in the world. So this is just a start for me. And I've worked so hard to get back on track these past 2 months.
Yeah, that's perfect.
And my goal was to finally get under 200 pounds. And I'm hoping I did that. That's incredible. I'm like 30 pounds from my target weight now, and 2 skin surgeries away from my goal. And that's amazing for me to even think about.
Hello.
Hi, Dr. Now.
How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
Great. You are down to 194 pounds. That's 455 pound weight loss.
That number is breathtaking to me.
I'm proud of you. You're doing great. Nikki is back to making good progress, and she's very close to her target weight. But I'm concerned about the treatment she received on her sutures. So let's take a look at you now.
Okay.
And deal with this wound back you mentioned. Okay, this is all wrong, and it's not looking good. And see this stuff in here, wound bag, don't pick that out. Mm-hmm. This needs to be picked up with the gauze. Okay. You should not have a wound bag on you at this point, and you're not healing because of it. It looked like Nikki went to some local doctors and got very bad medical treatment that has prevented her wound from closing. So I have removed the wound back and cleaned up that area. If she doesn't irritate it and keep it clean, then the opening will close and heal within a month or so. But she's still doing well, and I think we can get her there. I'm glad of you, okay?
Thank you. Thank you so much, Dr. Now.
I will see you later, okay?
I'll do it.
All right.
Thank you so much. Okay.